5 Love Languages. Hi guys, my name is Lena Semenek and welcome to Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life. Today I will talk about 5 Love Languages. There is a book written by Gary Chapman, which is called 5 Love Languages. And it's about 4.5 hours in audiobook and about 200 pages in paper book. So if you would like to read it, I will leave the link to both versions below this video. But if you don't have time to read the book, if you don't want to get an audio version and you want like a short crush story and the understanding, watch this video. In the next 5 minutes, I will share with you 5 love languages. Let's start. There are 5 love languages, and every person has his own primary love language. You might be doing a lot for your partner, but you feel like something is missing, or maybe your partner is complaining that you don't love him enough, or you're not doing something enough for him, and in your mind you're doing so many things, you're expressing your love, but for some reason your partner does not notice it, or telling you that it's not important and he wants something more, something different, and you cannot understand why. So a lot of divorces, misunderstandings, breakups are happening because people speak different love languages. The first love language is act of service. When you actually doing something for another person, making money, fixing his car, making dinner, helping him with his work, when you actually doing something physically for another person and for your relationship. The second love language is words of admiration. When you actually saying how much you love her. The girl wants to hear how much you love her, how beautiful she is, how pretty she is, how amazing she is, how important she is in your life, how happy you are to be with her. So for guys, usually it's just words, and guys usually don't understand why should they say all those words. It's just words, but for girl it might be extremely important. So if your girlfriend wants to hear it, you know, just accept it and tell her every day how much you love her. The third love language is quality time. Quality time together. When you go hiking, when you're playing tennis together, when you go to movie theater, when you're spending the day on the beach, when you enjoying some activities together. Quality time is actually when you and your partner are spending some time together doing something, watching something, exploring, talking, or just experience something together. Love language number 4 is receiving gifts, and this has nothing to do with being a gold digger. Usually for people who likes to receive gifts, quality is not as important as quantity. So if, for example, you bought your girlfriend a car and for the next 6 or 8 months you did not buy her anything, then she will feel that you don't love her. So for her, it's better to get like small gift, flowers, chocolate, something small and inexpensive, but every other day. And at the end of the month, it will be like 15, 20 gifts, and it means this is how much I love you. So receiving gifts usually is not about quality, it's about quantity. The more gifts, the more love. And love language number 5 is physical touch. Hugs, kisses, cuddling. A couple might sit for hours in front of the TV watching movies, or for hours on the beach watching waves. Physical touch is about actually being next to your partner and feeling your partner, touching your partner. If you and your partner have the same primary love language, then you are lucky. But in most cases, people have different love languages. For example, let's say you like physical touch. You like to spend hours in bed hugging your partner and sleeping next to him. And for him, he might have different love language, and maybe he wants to sleep on his side of the bed, and if you're gonna touch him and hug him all night, he might not get enough sleep, and in the morning he might be angry. For him, it's like, yes, I love you, you are my girlfriend, but I need 8 hours of sleep, and I would like to sleep on my side, and please let me, you know, sleep on my corner, and don't touch me, don't bother me, because I prefer to sleep in my own space. And for you, for example, it's unacceptable. If you're in bed with the man that you love, you want to feel him, you want to touch him, you want to hug him. For you, it's like, how can you sleep in the same bed without feeling your partner, without touching your partner? And if you're not doing it for you, you might feel like, oh my God, I feel lonely being in bed with my partner, with the person that I love. I feel so lonely. He does not love me. So it's not about actually that he does not love you. It's about different love languages. The main goal is to figure out what's your partner's primary love language and speak on using his primary love language. Also, the goal is to figure out what's your primary love language and tell your partner about it. And if you can find somehow a way to communicate and use each other love language, then you might have a happy, loving, profound relationship. If you would like to know how to figure out your partner's primary language, primary love language, leave your comments below and I will create a separate video for you. Also, check my other videos in the description of this one, how to have a happy, loving relationship, how to create a relationship that lasts long, secret of sexual and loving, passionate relationship. All links will be below this one. Send this video to your friends, subscribe to my channel, and thank you for watching Psychology of Happiness, where happiness is the purpose of life.